Vicious dear students, in today's class we will see about electrochemical extraction of aluminium by Hall-Herold process. Now alumina is obtained from bauxite ore. Formula for a bauxite ore is given: Al2O3 n times the water molecule. Alumina formula is Al2O3. Now alumina is concentrated to remove impurities by the method called alkali leaching. You have learnt about it in the earlier classes. Now the type of bond found within this molecule is covalent bond. What's the meaning of covalent bond? Covalent bond is formed by sharing electrons within them. When the electrons are shared within the molecule, there will not be free electrons available. If free electrons are not available, passing or conducting electricity is not possible. One more point, electricity is conducted at best when the metal is in the liquid state. Now there are two criteria for conducting electricity. One, the metal should be in the liquid state. Point number two, it should have a free electrons. Now in terms of alumina, free electrons are not available because covalent bond is formed within them. Point number two, it's in the solid state, not in the liquid state. So now, but we need to extract pure alumina. So we will begin to melt it. If for the melting point for the alumina is 2000 degrees Celsius, it's a quite high temperature and the cost efficient is also more. So what we can do here is, if you mix alumina with a cryolate, that's a molten cryolite, the temperature from 2000 degree, it comes down to 900 to 1000 degrees Celsius. What I mean here is, within this temperature, ionization of alumina takes place. What's the meaning of ionization of alumina? The molecule gets split into positive ions and negative ions. Why are we talking about a positive ions and negative ions? We are studying electrochemical method. Electrochemical method involves the redox reactions. I told you redox reaction meaning oxidation also takes place, reduction also takes place simultaneously. So once again I'm repeating, pure alumina, if we need to melt to conduct electricity, the temperature required is 2000 degrees Celsius. But when you mix it with a molten cryolite, the temperature required is only 900 to 1000 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, ionization of alumina in a cryolite molten takes place. Ionization meaning split, the molecule gets split into positive ions and negative ions. So before we move into electrolytic cell, let's have a quick recap of what we learnt in the previous video. Delta G naught is equals to minus NF E naught. What does it talk about? I told you electrochemical principle is based on the formula delta G naught is equals to minus NF E. Delta G naught talks about standard Gibbs free energy, that is energy available to do useful work. Minus sign talks about work is being done. N stands for number of electrons involved in the reduction. F stands for Faraday, that is quantity of electricity passed for the electrolysis. E naught talks about electrode potential. Now the whole of this reducing agent, the selection of reducing agent depends on the E naught value that we get from here. Now E naught value is negative, delta G will be positive. I have shown it in the previous video, kindly watch it again. So if E naught value is negative, delta G is positive. If delta G is positive, if you remember, the slope goes up the graph, so the reaction is non-spontaneous. Now, if delta naught is positive, if E naught is positive, delta G is negative. If delta G is negative, the slope comes down the graph. Here the reaction is spontaneous. So the purpose of finding out the E naught value is to know whether the reaction is possible or not possible. Now we'll move into the topic electrolytic cell. Now in electrochemical method, you need to have an electrolytic cell. Now when you talk about an electrolytic cell, you need to have a anode, you need to have a cathode, and you need to have an electrolyte. Now, in this case, iron tank is taken. I have given the points, I mean parts for you all. Iron tank is taken. It's being coated by carbon. That I have kind of darker thing I have given it to you. It's coated with a carbon. So this coated with a carbon acts as a cathode, and a cathode is connected to negative terminal of the battery. Now, carbon blocks is being immersed in the electrolytic setup. Now, this carbon blocks acts as an anode, and it anode means positive. So it's connected to the positive end of the terminal. At the lower part, you have an outlet. After all the reaction takes place for the pure alumina to drain out. Now, anode, you know, it's the carbon blocks are taken at anode, and coated carbon is taken at a cathode here. And the mixture of what type of electrolyte is taken, as we have seen, it's a mixture of cryolite and alumina. So mixture of cryolite and alumina is taken. They are in the molten state. Now, one more thing, calcium chloride, that CaCl2, CaCl2, calcium chloride is being added to lower the melting point of the mixture. Next point, the temperature within this cell should be around 1270 Kelvin or 997 degree Celsius. Now, after all this setup, we pass the current, so the reaction takes place here. So now, as I told you, ionization of alumina. What's the meaning of ionization of alumina? The molecule gets split into positive ions and negative ions. Now, redox reactions for the charge is very, very important. I'm not going to go in detail about the charges over here, because in the preparation and chemical properties of potassium dichromate and potassium permanganate, you will learn in detail about the redox reactions. So now I'm coming back to the point, ionization of alumina. It splits into positive ions and negative ions. So Al3+ talks about, now the charge of aluminium is 3+, charge of oxygen is 2-. 3+ talks about one aluminium has 3 electrons. You know, one aluminium is running short of 3 electrons. So how many aluminium we have taken? 2 aluminium. So one aluminium, 3 electrons, they are running short. So 2 aluminium, how many electrons they will be running short? 6 electrons. Now one oxygen is having, minus stands for excess of electron. One oxygen is having 2 electron in excess. How many oxygen we have taken? 3 oxygen. So 3 2s are 6. So there are 6 electrons excess here. Here they are running short of 3, I mean 1 aluminium, 3. So the 2 aluminium will be 6 electrons are running short, and 6 electrons are in excess. Now reaction at cathode. Now as I told you, after the ionization, Al2O3, that's the alumina, gets split into Al3+O2-. Now positive ions will move towards the cathode, which is a negative charge. Negative ions will move towards the anode, which is of positive charge. So reaction at cathode, Al3+ ions move towards the cathode. Cathode is a richer in electron sources. How many electrons it requires to convert it into a metal, complete metal? 6 electrons, because 1 aluminium requires 3 electrons. So 2 aluminium, 6 electrons. So it accepts the 6 electrons from the cathode and becomes a pure aluminium metal in the form of a liquid. Now reaction at anode. Now as I told you, negative charge will move towards the positive anode. So how many electrons now? Oxygen is a diatomic molecule. One oxygen, diatomic, when you say oxygen, O2. So how many oxygen I've got here? 3 oxygen. So together, if it's a diatomic, 3 2s are 6. How many oxygen I will have to take? 6 oxygen. One oxygen is having a 2 electron in excess. So how many oxygen here? 12 electrons. So how many electrons are excess here after the formation of oxygen molecule? 12 electrons are excess. Now one more point here. Carbon also acts as an anode. So there will be some more reactions. The oxygen molecule left alone in the molten state or in the solution will move towards the anode, and some type of reaction will take place here. If the carbon accepts one oxygen atom, so the product formed will be carbon monoxide. One oxygen has got 2 excess of electrons, so 2 electron goes out. On the other hand, if carbon accepts two atoms of oxygen. So 2 2 4, so 4 it will form a carbon dioxide plus 4 electrons will be in excess. Now overall reactions, if we see here, 4 times Al3 plus plus 6 times O2 minus combines with the 3 carbon to give you aluminium plus carbon dioxide. Now, as I told you, aluminium is running short of 3 electrons. So, how many aluminium atoms we have taken? 4. So, 4 threes are 12. They are running short of 12 electrons. 1 oxygen is having 2 electrons in excess. How many oxygen atoms are there? 6. So 6 2s are 12. So 12 electrons are in excess. So aluminium is running short of 12 electrons. Oxygen is running oxygen has 12 electrons in excess. So they balance one another. Pure aluminium goes out. The remaining number of oxygen and carbon get together to form a carbon dioxide gas. Thank you. I gave you my heart.